Hola everypony, mi llamo es Crystal Bloodsucker, also known as Serena Earthpony, and I am back with another fanfic reading! Yay! Now, this fanfic is another piece of work that I wrote myself that I call Underground. It's basically just a crossover between Labyrinth and Invader Zim. I'll leave a link for it in the description below so that you can read it for yourselves if you want. Anyway, let's get to the reading, and I hope you enjoy. It was a nice, lovely evening in the green park of the city. On one of the park benches sat a strange-looking young boy. He had green skin, black hair, and purple eyes. He was wearing a maroon sweater with black stripes, the sleeves being pink with black stripes, black gloves, black slacks, and black boots. On his back, he was wearing a gray backpack with three pink spots. He sat on the bench casually, one leg crossed over the other, as he stared down at the object in his hands. It was a little brown book with the title written in gold cursive. The title of the book said Labyrinth on it. The boy seemed very engrossed in the story, until the sound of a twig snapping in front of him caused him to look up. Standing in front of him was another young boy, probably the same age. He had white skin, black hair in a scythe style, and brown eyes behind round black glasses. He wore a long black trench coat over a blue t-shirt with a neutral face, black slacks, and black boots. The boys stared at each other as he slowly approached. "Give me the child," the boy demanded softly. "Through dangers untold and hardships unnumbered, I have fought my way here to the castle, beyond the Goblin City, to take back the child you have stolen." The green child uncrossed his legs and leaned forward, eager to catch every word the other boy was saying. "For my will is as strong as yours, and my kingdom is as great." The boy seemed to be drawing a blank as he stood there on the lawn, blushing with complete embarrassment. The green boy shook, agitated at this moment. "Come on, Dib, you know this one," he whispered to himself. The boy referred to as Dib stood there for a few more seconds before sighing. "Line, please, Zim." The other child groaned and slapped his hand to his forehead. Come on, Div, this is the third take. It's the most important scene in the whole play. Well, I'm sorry that I keep forgetting my lines, Div frowned as he snatched the book away and looked at his lines. You have no power over me. How hard is it to remember a line as simple as that? Zim shouted. Hey, it's not that easy, Div frowned at him. I'd like to see you go through all your lines in one go and not get all jumbled up. Oh, please, Div Stink. I'm nothing more than the mere villain, Zim rolled his eyes. All I have is just a few lines, one monologue, and two songs, and that's it. This play is all focusing on you, since because you're the main character. Yeah, what's up with that anyway? Div crossed his arms, raising an eyebrow at himself. Why do I have to play as Sarah? Why couldn't they get some girl to do it? Hello, Dipworm. Were you not listening to anything Miss Bitters said? Zim rolled his eyes a second time. She said that the school board wants the class to do the play like they did in Shakespearean times. And, last time I researched, human-female worm babies were not allowed to act back in those times. Oh, yeah. Right. Dip blushed with embarrassment. You know you can't say those things when we're acting, right? What? Worm babies? Zim raised an eyebrow at him. Of course I know, Div Human. I'm not stupid.
Sometimes I wonder.
Zim growled and snatched the book back from his frenemy, almost giving him a paper cut. Can we just get these stupid lines over with before I... But before he could say anything else, the city's clock tower rang through the air. Zim and Div looked up to the clock and gasped.
Oh no, Div gasped when he saw the time. It's already 5 o'clock!
Didn't your dad unit say to be back at home at 4:30? Zim's eyes widened.
Yes! Come on! Div shouted as he started running. Oh man, I am so late!
And in trouble, Zim gasped as he started running too, trying to keep up with the other boy. The two ran as fast as they could through the town, trying to reach Div's house as fast as possible. As they ran, thunder roared up through the air as dark black rain clouds started swirling in. Quick thinking, Div ripped off his jacket and tossed it to Zim, who caught it mid-air and wrapped it around himself over his head, grateful for the protection from the harsh acid rain on his delicate, vulnerable skin.
Oh man, this is so not fair, Div whined up when the two of them finally reached Dib's house, Professor Membrane waiting for them on the porch.
Oh really now, son, the genius father glared at him.
I'm sorry, Div smacked himself.
Never mind, son, I don't have time for this, Professor Membrane shook his head. Get inside and dry off, the both of you, before you catch a cold. I have to go down to the labs and work on that cure for cancer. Gaz has already eaten and is back on her game slave.
Okay, Dad, we won't bother her, Div nodded as they both entered. Come on, Zim, we can keep practicing our lines in my room.
You two are still practicing that stupid play of yours? Gaz snorted as she entered, her eyes never leaving her game slave.
Unfortunately, Div sister, yes, we are, Zim sighed, although we probably would have been done a lot sooner if your stupid big-headed brother would stop forgetting his lines.
My head's not big, Div growled, and if all you're going to do is insult me, then you can just go home and practice your lines by yourself.
Zim's eyes widened at this. Him? Practice his lines by himself? It was unthinkable. He had no idea what he was doing. He didn't know how to act. It was the only reason why he was working with the Div Beast to begin with. He quickly scrambled up the stairs, trying to catch up with the human.
Wait, Div! He cried as they entered his room. I'm sorry. Can we just practice these lines and be done with this?
Fine, Div huffed, crossing his arms. Zim smiled with approval. He went over to Div's bed and sat down, pulling the book out.
Let's start with the beginning, he suggested. It's just as important as the ending line.
All right, fine, Div rolled his eyes as he went to the center of the room. He stood in the middle of his room, took a few breathers, and then looked at the alien, giving him a quick nod. Zim nodded back, holding his three-fingered hand up, counting down. Once upon a time, there was a beautiful young girl whose stepmother always made her stay home with the baby. And the baby was a spoiled child. He wanted everything for himself, and the girl was practically a slave.
But what no one knew was that the Goblin King fell in love with her and gave her certain powers. So one night, when the baby had been particularly cruel to her, she asked the goblins for help. "Say your right words," the goblins said, "and we'll take the baby to the Goblin City, and you will be free." But the girl knew the king of the goblins would keep the baby in his castle forever and ever, and turn it into a goblin. So she suffered in silence, until one night, when she was tired from doing housework, and hurt by the harsh words of her stepmother, and she could no longer stand it.
"That's it, Dib. Just say the words," Zim nodded eagerly.
"I can bear it no longer! Goblin King! Goblin King! Wherever you may be, take this child of mine far away from me!"
Suddenly, there was an ear-splitting shriek downstairs. Zim and Dib looked at each other, their faces pale. What the heck was that? Zim slowly stood up from the bed and approached the door. He opened it slowly. It was pitch black in the hall. Dib gulped as he cautiously approached. Stepping out into the hall was his irking frenemy. They looked down the stairs. Complete darkness.
Gaz? Dib nervously called. "Is that you?"
There was no answer.
"Dib, sister? Is everything all right?" Zim called next.
Still no answer. The two boys looked at each other, fear coursing through their veins. Did something happen to her? Quickly, the two of them ran down the stairs, calling Gaz's name as they stumbled. Just as they turned the corner, a strange creature jumped in front of them and screamed. Zim and Dib screamed back in utter terror, jumping into each other's arms. The creature looked absolutely terrifying. It had the hideous face of a pig, long straggly black hair, and torn up cow ears on the side. Its skin glistened with blood and sweat. The creature continued to scream and squeal, flinging its purple-sleeved arms in the air.
Wait, purple-sleeved arms?
Gaz? Zim and Dib both cried out.
Gaz laughed hysterically as she pulled the pig mask off her head, laughing at the two boys in front of her.
"You guys should have seen your face," she laughed at them. "It was hysterical."
"Gaz, why on earth would you do that?" Dib growled at her
when he and Zim had calmed down.
"How could I not?" she laughed again. "You guys were upstairs, practicing your stupid lines for your stupid play so loudly I could hear you all the way down here. And then when you screamed the words, you made me lose my game because I was distracted. I had to do something to get my revenge."
"Is your stupid game slave the only thing you ever care about?" Dib hissed.
"That and pizza," Gaz hissed back.
"Oh my god, you are so heartless," Dib sneered. "Do you always think about just yourself?"
"Let me think. How long have you known me?"
Dib growled as he glared at his sister. Sometimes he wondered if they were related at all.
"Oh my gosh, Gaz, I never realized it before, but you are so annoying," he hissed at her. "You are just like the baby in our play. Cruel, heartless, spoiled, and thinks about only themselves. If the goblins were real, I wish them to take you away."
"Dib!" Zim gasped.
Zim was shocked. He had never seen the two siblings lash out at each other like this, especially Dib. Usually, Dib would be afraid to say such things to Gaz, but it was obvious that Dib had reached his breaking point with his scary little sister, and he was no longer scared of her, just really angry. Dib spat at the floor by Gaz's feet and grabbed Zim's wrist, dragging him back up the stairs. Just before he slammed the door to his bedroom, he stuck his head out to the hall and screamed back down the stairs.
"I hate you, Gaz! I wish the goblins would come and take you away! Right now!"